With us today, we have respected Governor Shri Shaktikant Das.
I had said last time, just say Governor.
Okay, sir. We have Shri Shaktikant Das, Governor, Reserve Bank of India, with us, along with Dr. Michael Patra, Shri M. Rajeshwar Rao, Shri T. Ravi Shankar, and Shri Swaminathan J. Along with us also are Executive Directors Dr. O. P. Mal and Dr. Rajiv Ranjan, and my colleague from MPD and the secretaries. So we have 22 media persons present here, and as is our wont, we will first go with your opening remarks and then we'll go for the press conference. Yeah. Over to you, sir.
Thank you for being here. Good morning. You have already heard the statement. It's been uploaded also. As a part of initial remarks, I would like to make 9 points. First, domestic economic activity continues to be strong. We expect the real GDP to grow by 7% in the next financial year, 24-25. Second point, CPI inflation is moderating with intermittent interruptions and spikes. We have to remain vigilant about the incoming data and the outlook. Our endeavor to achieve 4% inflation on a durable basis has to continue. Third, globally, markets are front-running central banks in anticipation of policy pivots. But central banks remain apprehensive and await a more durable alignment of inflation with the targets. Four, liquidity will be actively managed by the Reserve Bank. Five, our multi-pronged, proactive and calibrated policies have worked well to maintain and strengthen macroeconomic and financial stability. Six, systemic, sectoral and institution-specific signs of stress are being proactively monitored and acted upon wherever necessary. Seven, let me reiterate that good governance, robust risk management, sound compliance culture, and protection of customers' interest are the hallmarks of the Reserve Bank's approach to the safety and stability of the financial system and individual financial institutions. Regulated entities must accord the highest priority to these aspects. This is the seventh point. The eighth point is the external sector of the economy remains resilient. The current account deficit is expected to be eminently manageable. Nine, the exchange rate of the Indian rupee has remained stable. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for those opening remarks. And may I request all of you to wait for your turn to be called, and request also to stick to one question. And if we have time, we'll go for the other or second or third question. So I'll begin by inviting Lata Venkatesh from CNBC TV18.
Thank you, Governor. Thank you, Yogesh. Confusion about whether you are distinguishing between liquidity and your stance. You have mentioned in three places that you're not, that the entire rate hike has not been fully transmitted. So I assume you want more hike transmitted. But separately, you have said that you will manage liquidity, para 21 in great detail, that you will manage liquidity with a bunch of instruments. Should we understand, therefore, that unlike the majority of the last 5 months when call was closer to 6.75, you will be more like you were in the last 1 week, where you will give long-term liquidity through repo and adjust for short-term, which is keep call rate closer to 6.5. Is that what you are trying to say, that I'll do that, but I want more interest rate hikes to happen? Yeah. And, sir, since you have dwelt twice on this good governance, I must add, are you trying to say that you will not give Paytm any further timeline to set them right? Does Feb 29 yeah. stand? Is that what
so
we should understand?
So there are two questions actually. Yes. Two questions. So please ask one question each. The first part of the question, I would request Deputy Governor Michael Patra to reply. The second part, I would request Deputy Governor Swaminathan to reply. Go ahead.
As Governor has clarified in his statement, the stance is all about the future course of policy rates.
A little louder.
Now, liquidity is endogenous to the rate. When the rate is the chief instrument of monetary policy, liquidity follows the rate. You have to move liquidity to achieve a certain rate. So our objective is to keep the repo rate, keep the weighted average call rate around the repo rate. But there are times when there are temporary drivers of autonomous liquidity, like government balances, which go through tectonic shifts, and market participants take time to adjust. Even they are unsure about the future direction of this. So that is why sometimes the call rate goes to where it went. But you saw that we were nimble in our actions and we brought it down to the repo rate. That is our endeavor.
But yeah. You were nimble after 5 months. So I'm asking, will you be like the previous five
no,
days?
That is,
or will you be like the last 5 days?
No, that is not correct, because at the time when the rates were up, we allowed market participants to take what liquidity they wanted from us through our standing facilities. And we did the main operation every 14th day. So it was not that we let it go. But it was the market participants still, you saw the reactions to the VRRR, they're unwilling to let go because they're unsure about how balances will move.
Yeah, as you know, as a matter of policy, we don't comment on individual entity or actions that we initiate in such cases. But that anyway, since this question is on the uppermost of mind of most of you, I think I would like to say 2-3 things, essentially to set the context. While we don't want to be discussing the individual details here, because that will not be proper. In terms of context, as you all know, that this is a supervisory action on a regulated entity for a persistent non-compliance. Second, such supervisory actions are invariably preceded by months and at times years of bilateral engagement, where we not only pointing out the deficiencies, but also provide more than adequate time for them to take corrective action. Third, of course, is in terms of, as a regulator, it's incumbent upon us to protect the interest of the ultimate consumer and thereby protecting the stability of the financial system. So these actions have to be seen in that particular context. Coming to the second part of your question, what lies ahead? You know, as part of MPC, we don't give a forecast in these matters. So I think we will have to wait, and of course, we have been getting feedback, we'll work on, and as a responsible regulator, suitable steps will be taken to ensure that the customer inconvenience, if any, is minimized. So we will take care. I think with that, we can give a rest to this question and then move on to MPC, is my request. Thank you.
Thank you, sirs. I'll move on to Mr. Govardhan Rangan from Economic Times.
So thank you, sir. So good afternoon, Governor. For the rate decision, the status quo, you specifically mentioned that the transmission of 250 basis points is still continuing. So the bankers say that the deposit rates have already gone up by 250 basis points and the lending rates have also gone up. So what, in your mind, is the actual transmission that has not happened, and how much is that? And what is the benchmark that you're looking at to conclude that the transmission has happened? Thank you.
Okay, again, like the previous questions, I would request, I think, DG Swaminathan, supplemented by DG Michael Patra, to reply to that question. Let there be wider participation. I don't want to monopolize all the answers. So, yeah, go ahead.
As far as the transmission in a hiking phase, as we have always seen in the past, the rates on deposit side, the resets much faster. And they get passed on, and as we have seen, deposit rates have almost played out. While on the lending side, it does take time to pass for two critical reasons in our assessment. There are two major reasons. One is that, the proportion of loans that are benchmarked externally, what we call EBLR linked loans is still less than 50%. So where the transmission could be instant is only where the EBLR comes into play. In case of other instruments, other benchmarks like MCLR or base rates or fixed rate loans, it does take time to transmit. So that is the precise reason why we still see that transmission is fully not in place. The second, also in a hiking pace, we have seen banks in their anxiety to maintain their market share in the incremental credit also adjust their margins so as not to lose their market share in the incremental credit. So that also impedes a complete transmission in terms of the effective interest rate. So I hope it has been understood from the context of these two parameters. Thank you.
Anything you would like to supplement? No. Yeah.
I'll move on to Mr. Ankur Mishra from ET now.
Sir, I would once again...
Mike.
This is again a matter of bilateral discussion, so I don't think that will be proper for us to discuss it in this forum. So as I said, discussing on individual entities will not be very proper, giving granular details in this matter. So we are seized of the issue, and as we take steps, we will keep the media and public certainly informed. Thank you.
You see, as the Deputy Governor has already commented, I mean, sufficient time, I'm again saying in a general sense, not specific to this case. We give sufficient time to every regulated entity, every entity that is supervised by the Reserve Bank to comply with the requirements, the regulatory requirements. We give sufficient time, and sometimes, as he pointed out, sometimes it may even look more than sufficient time. And we would not like to act, we are a responsible regulator, we are a responsible supervisor. If everything had been compliant, I'm talking about in a general sense, why should we act? I mean, after all, we have a responsibility, it's a responsible institution, RBI, so that's how it is, yeah.
Thank you, sir. Ab main amantrit karunga Jeevan Bhav, sir, All India Radio.
Namaskar, sir. पिछले कुछ सालों में पिछले कुछ महीनों में कुछ बैंकों ने अपने लेंडिंग रेट्स कम किए हैं, लेकिन जो कम किए हुए रेट्स का जो बेनिफिट्स है वो नए कस्टमर्स को दिया जा रहा है, पुराने कस्टमर्स अभी भी हायर रेट्स पे लेंडिंग रेट्स पे कर रहे हैं। तो इसके लिए, ये पैरिटी लाने के लिए आरबीआई कुछ इंस्ट्रक्शंस इशू करेगी या कुछ बैंकों के साथ टेकअप करेगी?
ये जो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स हैं जो नए कस्टमर्स को मिलता है, लेकिन एग्जिस्टिंग कस्टमर्स को भी ये फायदा होता है, जब वो रेट रीसेट होता है तब एग्जिस्टिंग कस्टमर्स को ये फायदा मिलता है। तो पॉलिसी चेंज की जरूरत नहीं है, क्योंकि जो गाइडलाइंस हैं फ्लोटिंग रेट इंटरेस्ट पे, उसके आधार पे दोनों एग्जिस्टिंग कस्टमर्स और नए कस्टमर्स दोनों को ये फायदा होगा। थैंक यू।
धन्यवाद सर। अब मैं आमंत्रित करता हूँ आनंद अधिकारी, बिजनेस टुडे।
Good afternoon, sir. I'll also make an attempt on PTM. DZ Swaminathan talked about this persistent non-compliance, and he also said in such cases, months and years of bilateral engagement. My question is, why did RBI not consider appointing a director on the board of PTM, when you knew about this persistent non-compliance issues?
See, as a regulator, we have various tools in the kitty. And it's not necessary that every single tool will be deployed in every single situation. That we make our own assessment to the scale and proportionality of the issue, as well as the tool that we will have to use at different points in time. So one size fits all kind of solution may not work in such situations. So, I would like to stop there rather than, trying to elaborate on that. We may use certain tools, may not use certain tools, but it is after a due consideration that we do. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I'll move on to Mr. Anoop Roy from Bloomberg.
Thank you, sir. Sir, the budget was non-inflationary and the government really brought down the fiscal deficit, etc., and the bond yields have fallen. So the government probably wants interest rates to come down, but RBI probably is keeping interest rates high. You are saying the transmission is not complete, etc. So is there a lack of coordination, sir?
No. I mean, has the government said anywhere that they want the interest rates to be brought down? So, therefore, it's a very speculative proposition. So, I cannot reply to that question.
Okay.